Hi, it's Katrina. From teleportation to exploding black holes, here are 10 ways quantum physics has changed our view of reality. Number 10. Time dilation. For hundreds of thousands of years, people have had a concept of the continual passage of time, whether they measured it by the movement of the sun across the sky, with wristwatches, and more recently, smartphones. Quantum physics, however, has shown that time isn't as constant as it seems, with a process known as time dilation. It's a part of Einstein's theory of special relativity, where he proved mathematically that the faster you travel, the slower time progresses. This reaches a critical point at the speed of light where time reaches a complete standstill. Of course, we currently have no way of getting anywhere near the speed of light, but there are experiments that can show the effects of time dilation. One such experiment involved synchronizing two highly accurate atomic clocks and taking one on a journey on a high-speed aircraft. When the plane returned, the clock that had been traveling on it was behind the other one that remained stationary, proving that time had passed more slowly. Number 9. The different types of water. When you have a glass of water, how many different types of water do you think the glass is filled with? It sounds like a strange question, but equally as strange is the answer, because there are actually two different forms. This would be a good question for Trivial Pursuit. As we know, a water molecule is made up of a large oxygen atom along with two hydrogen atoms, but the hydrogen atoms can be arranged in two different ways based on their quantum spin, something that is similar to ball spinning but involves movement through extra dimensions. Water molecules where the hydrogen atoms spin in the same direction is known as ortho water, and when the hydrogen atoms spin in a different direction, it's known as para water. Because the spin only affects water molecules on the quantum level, it's virtually impossible to separate the two different types, but recent studies have managed to perform experiments on each of them separately. Surprisingly, para water has been found to react 25% faster than ortho water. This is believed to happen because of the way that the difference in spin attracts other molecules. Further investigation into this phenomenon will hopefully help understand how quantum spin influences every chemical reaction that happens, and potentially give a new way in which reactions can be manipulated. Number 8. The fifth state of matter. We all learned about the states of matter in science class and how elements transition between solid, liquid, gas, and plasma, but quantum physics has enabled the creation of a fifth state of matter known as Bose-Einstein condensates, which itself allows more experimentation in the weird world of quantum physics. The first Bose-Einstein condensate was made in 1996 by cooling rubidium close to absolute zero. At this temperature, there's virtually no energy at all in the molecules, and very little movement being passed between them. This means they begin to clump together, and instead of there being thousands of individual atoms, there becomes one superatom. This unusual atomic arrangement allows researchers to study quantum mechanics on a macroscopic level, and light even appears to slow down as it passes through a BEC, which allows the study of the particle/wave paradox. They also behave in a similar way to a superfluid and can be used to replicate the conditions that are thought to exist in a black hole. And now for number 7. But first, be sure to subscribe if you are new here and join the Origins Explained family. Number 7. Neutrino origins. Neutrinos are mysterious particles that pass through virtually everything, which makes them incredibly difficult to study. But recent experiments, such as the Ice Cube Neutrino Observatory, have given opportunities to detect them and even learn about their origins. A recent paper detailed what happened when scientists tracked where a neutrino had come from, and they couldn't believe what they found. Based on this, now models of the universe have to be rewritten. Neutrinos are high-energy particles, and very little is understood about what creates them. Detection experiments rely on them colliding with other elements, which is a rare event. This creates another particle known as a muon, which can then be detected by specialized equipment. One neutrino that was found in late 2017 had been traveling across the universe for 4 billion years, longer than life has been present on Earth. And by pointing telescopes in the direction it had come from, it turns out it was formed in one of the most destructive forces ever witnessed, a blazar. Named because of the blaze of electromagnetic energy that they fire out, blazars are supermassive black holes that are surrounded by galaxies. While they have been known about for a while, there's something about blazars that's able to accelerate neutrinos to incredibly high energies, something that had previously not been thought possible. Number 6. Objects can have two temperatures. Schrödinger's cat is a famous experiment from quantum physics that shows how a cat in a box can be alive and dead at the same time because of quantum mechanics. But a recent study has proven that a similarly weird phenomenon also exists that means that objects can be two temperatures at the same time on the quantum level. The Heisenberg principle that was first proposed in 1927 stated that the more precisely you measure the position of a quantum particle, the less precisely you can know its momentum, and vice versa. And now it's been found that the more precisely you measure temperature, the less you can know about its energy. This has massive implications for new branches of nanoscience, where researchers are working with minute objects such as quantum dots. Thermometers that we use in everyday life have a defined energy and will tell us an exact temperature, but quantum thermometers cannot have a well-defined energy and can be in a number of states at the same time, which further adds to the uncertainty. They could measure things below the nanometer scale at two different temperatures, so new frameworks are being designed on how to accurately measure temperature by taking into account the quantum uncertainties. Good luck with that one. Number 5. Quantum teleportation. Have you ever watched a sci-fi show like Star Trek and wished that their teleportation technology was real? We could completely eliminate travel time! Well, quantum teleportation is actually a thing, but it's not something that could allow actual objects to be moved from place to place. In 2017, scientists were able to transport photons from Tibet to a satellite that was more than 300 miles overhead in what is thought to be the next method of secure communication. The most complex things this can be done with are photons, neutrons, and electrons because of their quantum states. Two photons spinning clockwise are identical, and while one can't be instantaneously sent somewhere else, duplicates can be formed straight away. The reason why this is useful is that quantum teleportation can be used to transmit the data needed to decipher complex encryptions. Let's say you've sent an encrypted file that needs a key to unlock it. How do you send the key without risk of it being intercepted? The answer is that you send one half of two paired photons. Once you know the other person has received it, you can then encode the cipher into the one that you've kept, and it will be replicated on the other. This can then be read, and the information can be used to decipher the file. Since the photon doesn't contain the information when it's sent, there's no risk of it being intercepted and read. The human body, however, contains 10 octillion atoms. To transport that would require breaking the body down, which would be fatal, and then rearranging atoms at the destination. Even if it were possible, would that count as transportation or replication? And would you even be the same person on the other side? What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Number 4. Quantum life. It has always been thought that the behaviors of particles on the quantum scale, such as entanglement, were limited to inorganic molecules, but recent studies have suggested some bacteria can be quantum entangled. The weirdness of quantum physics is typically thought of as being something that happens on the minute scale, far smaller than bacteria, but there's an area of study looking at where the boundary between the quantum world and our world actually is, and things don't appear to be clear-cut. In fact, some researchers think there isn't necessarily a boundary at all, and that quantum effects could influence everything. Bacteria have been shown to be entangled with light particles, and in theory, there should be no reason why much larger objects can't also be entangled. They just contain far more atoms, so it's much more difficult. If you look at another person, for example, they're a completely different entity, aren't they? Well, there's no physical law that says this has to be true, and in the same way to entangled atoms that replicate each other's state no matter how far apart they are, perhaps the same could one day be possible for humans. Sometimes twins have instant thoughts between themselves. Could this already be proof of quantum entanglement on a human scale? Number 3. New particles. The standard model of particle physics is the theory that classifies all known elementary particles, as well as describing three of the four fundamental forces. It includes ones you'll have heard of, like electrons, the three types of neutrino, and quarks, and a few you may not have heard of, like tau, muon, boson, and gluon particles. But there's a problem. Detection arrays over Antarctica have twice detected the presence of a high-energy cosmic particle that's passed through the Earth and come out the other side, in a way that no known or theorized particle should be able to. It has been calculated that there's less than a 1 in 3.5 million chance that this particle is one of the ones already in the standard model, so it's highly likely that there's still another one yet to be discovered. This means that evidence is mounting that our current understanding of things is incomplete, and the world of particle physics could be about to get even more complicated. Number 2. Bell's theorem. Bell's theorem, named after John Stuart Bell, is a way to distinguish the properties of the quantum world from that of classical physics. It says that no physical theory of local hidden variables can ever reproduce all of the predictions of quantum mechanics, which means, in simpler terms, that looking for hidden reasons to explain why things are behaving in the way in which they are will never explain the full story. The reason why this is so profound is in the case of quantum entanglement. Some separated particles can share common properties and be measured as if they were the same particle, but this can happen over extreme distances, which means the information being shared between the particles is traveling faster than the speed of light. Physics, of course, states that this is impossible, which is where the issues of entanglement arise. Of course, the answer to how this is possible is still not known, but Bell's theorem has proved that it's not simply local, unknown forces behind it. Number 1. Hawking radiation. The most influential physicist of our time, Stephen Hawking, progressed our understanding of the quantum world an incredible amount, but possibly his greatest discovery was the one named after him, Hawking radiation. As we know, black holes are incredibly dense objects, so much that even light cannot escape their grasp. Or can it? Hawking wanted to measure the temperature of a black hole and took elements of Einstein's theory of relativity and quantum theory to be able to do so. He showed, however, that black holes can actually shrink and die, which means that they aren't necessarily the all-consuming monsters that they are so often described as being. The way this happens is quite weird, though. Quantum physics says that across the universe, particles and their associated counterparticles are popping in and out of existence. Usually, they don't last for long because they collide and eliminate each other. But if this happens on the edge of a black hole, it's possible for one of the linked pairs to fall in and for the other to escape. The one that falls in has negative energy, and the one that escapes has positive energy, and is known as Hawking radiation. The bizarre thing, though, is that the particle with negative energy that's pulled into the black hole essentially subtracts mass from it, and this process means that eventually, every black hole will evaporate and even explode. As Hawking said himself, things can get out of a black hole, so if you feel that you are in a black hole, don't give up. Thanks for watching! Hope you learned something new today! Be sure to subscribe for more, and I'll see you soon. Bye!